me now. Well, good morning or good afternoon or good evening, summer econ students. I'm making this video as a video version of your orientation. So I want to show you how the Blackboard site is going to operate and basically how you can succeed in the summer class for AP dual enrolled economics. It's actually macroeconomics, but most people just say economics. Anyway. We're starting here in the calendar because the calendar has all of your due dates listed. All right. We basically have three units of study, and those units of study have three main components to them. Okay. There's a daily or an assignment for each lesson. All right. It's a real quick, just kind of like test question version of the assignment. There is a test for each unit. And that test also includes a free response portion. So there's actually two things you turn in for the test. And I'll go over all this. I'm just kind of giving you an overview here. And then lastly, there's a discussion for each unit. Okay. Then we also have a short little paper to write. It's actually not anything to get bent out of shape about. It'll be on the second to last day of the course. That's on the 23rd. I'll go to that assignment in a second so you can see it. And then lastly, we have our final exam on the 24th. Okay? So that's the calendar. It gives you all the due dates. You can even click on the actual calendar entry to find the assignment in case you don't see it in course content. Anyway, let's move on. I will communicate to you through announcements. Okay? The announcements are going to also be emailed to you, but in case you don't check your email, you can always go to the announcement screen in Blackboard. This first announcement is very thorough. It basically tells you everything about the class. Okay? Some people prefer to read. Some people like to watch this little video, whatever. All right, so you guys can read through that on your own. Anyway, that's through the announcements. Teacher info, y'all can read about. This section here called course information, that's kind of where I'd like you to start just to get all the details about the course. After that first day in orientation, you can leave that alone because there's not really any additional information in there. It gives you an idea of what economics is. You can open this and read about it. There's also possible careers in economics for those of you that are interested. The syllabus and textbook, I am going to open that real quick. So the textbook is called Krugman's Economics for AP. It's actually Krugman's Macroeconomics for AP. You do not need the latest edition. I have seen this book on Amazon for $10. So you do not have to buy the $200 book through any kind of website that's mandated. All right. In addition to that, though, if you read this, it says there are PDFs of the relevant modules located in each lesson's folder in course content. We'll look at that in a sec. So those of you that don't mind reading a book on a computer screen, you don't even have to buy a book. All right, let me go to the syllabus so that you can look at that. A lot of times you guys will send me a question, and if it's an easy answer, I'll just send you a quick answer back. Otherwise, I might just say, hey, go read the syllabus. Okay, so you can read the syllabus. A lot of the syllabus just has information from Eastfield that is required. But here's probably the pertinent information for us. Your grade will consist 60% of the tests. All right, there's three unit tests, there's a written research assignment, and then a final exam. Again, I want to reiterate, the written research assignment is not hard. It's going to take a couple of hours on that second to last day of the course. Then there are discussion questions. There's three unit discussions and an introductory one. There's a rubric for that, and I'll show you that in a sec. And then 10% are the lesson assignments, okay? So that's where you'll get your grades. Let me close that out. All right. So I'm leaving that section. Go back to the course information. The due dates. In addition to the calendar, all the due dates are listed right here. Okay. Again, you'll probably just use the calendar. No big deal. Grading policy is very straightforward. Do not accept late work. This is probably kind of important. Those of you that have gone through the coronavirus COVID-19 spring semester, you probably noticed there was not such a thing as late. You could turn in work whenever. That's not the case in the summer assignments or the summer course, because in the summer course, it was meant to be online anyway. So due dates are set in stone. You may not turn in anything late. You can turn things in early. You can work early, but late grades will not be accepted. All right, that's very important. I'll explain why when we start looking at examples of the assignments. All right, let me move on. All right, you know who I am in my email. Netiquette, that might be important as we communicate. Let's see, student learning objectives, y'all can look at that. All right, so let's move on to probably the most important folder, which is course content. That is where everything is laid out, okay? And you'll notice, so I've got some tutorial videos y'all can go to. If you go to that link, it'll take you to the YouTube page, and it just lists, you know, videos by topic. Feel free to look through those if you want. I also have videos as a part of each lesson, so you can find those very easily. Here's our introductory discussion. Okay, this is actually due the first Thursday, I believe it's the first Thursday of the summer course. Again, that'll be in the calendar, so you can double check that. So y'all can do that on your own. Anyway, the units of study are listed here. So I've got Unit 1, we have Unit 2, Unit 3. If you are going to take the AP exam next May, then this unit here about the international trade, that is optional, but if you're gonna take the AP exam, you should do it, okay? You can do it after this course is over, whenever you want to. I'm just letting you know the AP exam has that on it, whereas the summer course does not, okay? Unit 4 is the research assignment. I have not updated this with the due dates yet, but I'll open it real quick just so you can kind of get an idea of what it is. Basically, I give you some sites you can go to, and you can look up some economic data. So by researching the data, you're then gonna write an expository essay explaining the current state of the economy. Okay. In addition to that, you'll draw some graphs, explain the graphs, and then lastly, just analyze something. Okay. This is old information here, so I'll have you find something new about that. Anyway, I will update that soon, definitely before it's time for you to do it. Okay. Let me go back now to course content again. Then you have a review folder. Okay, so if you want to do a quick review before you take the final exam, you can go through that information. And then lastly is the final exam, and then you will be finished with the course. Now, what I want to do is go into Unit 1 to kind of give you an idea of how each unit is structured. Okay, so first, there is a notes template and lesson summary document. This is something that might be useful to you, depending on how good you are at taking notes. So first thing I've done is I've summarized each lesson's textbook, okay? So if you want to, for example, Unit 1, Lesson 1, that's our Introduction to Economic Thinking, you can read through this and it'll be pretty much the same as reading through your textbook, okay? Gives you examples of things. And then I have a template for note-taking. Now, I don't require you to use any of this. You can take notes however you want. But this kind of outlines the important part of the notes, okay? So like if you were reading through the book, you know, a lot of times we summarize every paragraph in our notes or something, and that's just not necessary. So this gives you kind of a summary of what's important in the notes, all right? And then of course I give you a summary of what was important there as well. All right. Continuing on, I'm going to move into a particular lesson. How about this second one? Unit 1, Lesson 2. It's about economic models and one model in particular called the Production Possibilities Curve. And then I'd let you know that this is from your textbook, Modules 3 and 4. So I'm opening the folder. And for some reason, What the student version of Blackboard, it kind of gives you a condensed view. None of the images show up right away. So I want you to notice where it says table of contents. Or, more importantly, if you're the way you have your Blackboard set up, this might be hidden. Okay? See how now you don't see it? Well, what it does is it opens up the very first thing that is in the folder. And the very first thing in the folder happens to be the textbook pages for that lesson. So you can read through the textbook, okay? By the way, these graphs in the textbook, very important, okay? You don't gloss over those. Those are extremely important. Graphs and vocabulary are probably the most important things as you go through this course. All right. Anyway, going back to the table of contents, let's open that thing back up. Okay, the very first thing in every lesson is going to be the textbook. Okay, the second thing is going to be the PowerPoint notes. Okay, so if you'd like to go through the PowerPoint, okay, I've got that here. Probably is going to take a minute to open because they're kind of big. So yeah, it's going to load. So y'all can look through that. Okay, if I go back to that table of contents, I'll have a video. Okay, let's say you took notes and you're kind of like a little unsure of what it is you just watched. Here's the video over those notes. Okay, may have to click a couple things depending. Anyway, this will open up the video. Oh, it's kind of loud. Anyway, it'll take you through a video lecture of what was in the reading or what was in the notes. Okay, so y'all can do that. I'm going back. Anyway, after you've looked at all these things, now this one, look what it did here. So this is why it can be a little confusing depending on how your Blackboard does this. When we clicked on the video, it actually took us to a new page, so I have to hit the back button to go back to the other page. All right, so I'm back. Let's see. Oh, the assignment. This is important. So every lesson has an assignment. The assignment contains probably 10 questions, okay? And if you begin the assignment, it's going to open us up here to those 10 questions. And these 10 questions are going to be based on basically what you read, what you took notes on, what you watched a video on, okay? And each of these questions is really just designed to make sure that you grasped the content. Okay, you can do these assignments as many times as you want. There's between, I'm going to say, 8 and 10 lessons per unit. And those 8 to 10 assignments that are in each unit are going to make up your grade for the assignment portion of that unit, which is really only 10% of your grade. Okay, but like I said, you can do it as many times as you want. Since it's only 10% of your overall grade, though, If you've done the assignment like 12 times and you're still getting like an 80, if I were you, I would move on, okay? It's probably not worth your time and effort to get the extra 20 points up to 100 because, again, this is just one assignment out of 8 or 10 that make up 10% of your overall grade for that unit, okay? So that's kind of where we are as far as course content goes, okay? And again, you can look through this. Looks like unit 1 has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lessons, okay? And within those 6 lessons, there's 6 assignments. At the end of the unit, there's a discussion, all right? And then at the end, after the discussion, you have your exam. Let me open this up, though. Inside the exam, you have a multiple choice portion, which requires Respondus. You will need to download the latest version of Respondus from the Blackboard login screen. After you're done with that, you have the Unit 1 free response. Now, this is super important, all right? This is not timed. You open it up. You take all of your answers on paper. And after you're finished, you will take a picture of that paper and you will upload that to Blackboard. Now, I'm going to read this very carefully. If you need multiple pics, do not take pictures. Instead, use an app like CamScanner. Okay, you can download that free from the App Store or Google or whatever. And you can attach your pics to a Word document. OK, Okay, either one of those is fine. The point, though, is this. Blackboard will only allow one document to be uploaded. So if you take, you know, three pictures and you try to upload three pics, Blackboard's only going to upload one of those, which means when I go to grade this free response question, I'm only going to have a portion of your free response, which means your grade is going to be really, really low. So if you follow the directions, you will not be penalized. If you do load one portion of your answer, I'm only going to grade that one portion, and you're going to lose points. So please follow all the directions. Okay. Last thing about this free response. Right here, it says, do not use a file extension that is unrecognized by Blackboard. Okay, every year somebody does this, and I think it's Apple. They have a file format called Pages, and Blackboard does not recognize it. Okay, so if you upload your answers in a format called Pages, I'm gonna click on it. It's gonna basically tell me there's nothing there, and I'm going to give you a zero for that. Okay, so make sure you upload things correctly. If you're unsure, JPEGs work, PDFs work, Word documents work. Okay, so I'm going to move on and get out of that. I'm going back to course content. Unit one, sorry. Let's look at the discussion. All right, so your discussion is basically, I'm going to probably use in each one some current event. If in this one you'll see it's a current event about the coronavirus, so feel free to read through that. There's an article. You can click the article here or here. Okay, one will download a PDF version of it, the other will take you directly to the website. Since web links sometimes get broken, I saved it as a PDF, so either one of those will work. All right, so here's what you're going to do on each of these. Okay, you will answer the questions that are outlined in the instructions. Okay, so this one says, using your knowledge of scarcity, opportunity cost, supply, demand, equilibrium, shortages, and surpluses, discuss the economic reasoning for the changes that have taken place in the toilet paper market, as well as other markets affected by the changes in the toilet paper market. Okay, now that sounds silly, right? But there are actual economic reasons why things have happened. So I want you to discuss what has happened using your economic knowledge gained in Unit 1, and then discuss a measure or action that could be taken that would eliminate shortages. Okay? So you're going to learn about shortages, you're going to learn why they happen, and then that means if you know why a shortage happens, you should know how to fix one. Okay? So I want to know what you would do. Additionally, discuss some other markets that may see changes as a result of continuing stay-at-home orders. Okay, now down here, I want you to look through the discussion rubric. It's very important. Okay, I will grade your discussion answers based on this rubric. So read through this rubric, make sure it makes sense to you. But basically, use economic So that's the discussion rubric. All right, and every unit has a discussion. Go back to course content again. I'm in unit one. I think we're in good shape here. The point though, let me open another one here. So unit one, lesson 3B. The main point is this, for you guys to know how to navigate the course, okay? So again, when I clicked on unit one, lesson three, or whatever it was, it immediately opened up the textbook. Okay, go to your other link or web page rather. Okay, you know how you get folders up at the top. Open the previous folder and it'll take you back to this table of contents. Okay, and in each lesson I have laid it out exactly as follows: the textbook, then the PowerPoint notes, then the video. Okay, If a lesson has two actual lectures to it, then you'll have a second set of notes, okay? Second video, possibly, and then the last thing in it is the assignment. Make sure you always do the assignment so that you can get some practice with the content and move on. Okay? Anyway, I think that's basically it. I'm going back to the calendar now because I want to make sure you know that everything is always in the calendar. Okay? You can find what's due on every date that there's a due date. If you have questions, you email me. I will email you back. If you need a one-on-one conversation, we can talk on the phone. If anybody, you know, wants to have some sort of Zoom tutorial, we can do that as well. And again, just want to reiterate this. You can do all of these assignments early, but you cannot do any of them late. All right? Anyway, if you have any questions, please let me know. Other than that, that concludes our orientation, and I look forward to hearing from you. Thanks.